Hello, everybody, and welcome to a long overdue episode of Jurassic World Alive. Before we get into it, link in the description down below to collect 50 free books. All you need to do is open this or watch this video on whatever device you play Jurassic World Alive on, and you should be good. Just click on that and it'll open up into the game, and Bob's your uncle. You're welcome. Uncle Beaver takes care of 50 books cash just for you. So, why are we here today? Of course we're here today because there is a new Hadros Lux boss. This is kind of tying into, I assume, the whole, Camp Cretaceous, that's the one. Camp Cretaceous, the bioluminescent paras, except for instead of, you know, being bioluminescent and just a para, they made it a cool bioluminescent para hybrid thing. I'm hoping, I'm not really too sure how true this is. We need to add cat. Ooh, did you accept my friend request? I'll have a look. Because without, you know, I want to actually win this. So I'm adding from, I think it is Killer Raptors Squad. So hold on 2 seconds while I check my friends list. Ooh, hold on. I've got a Dart and a Montosaurus first. Here we go, guys. Ooh, the raid. Ooh, so, okay. Right. Now, I have never done this before. This could be interesting. We've got the Hadrosaur. What are the moves that the Hadrosaur actually has? So it has 100,000 health, group taunting shield, greater emergency heal, which only heals at 3,000, which isn't that much. Because if it healed itself, like, I don't know, 50,000, that'd be ridiculous. Resilient impact. Now, I've heard that when that happens, you've got to do your shield with Ardentus Maximum. So I'll be Ardentus, I think they wanted me to be, because we've got a lot to talk about. There's a load of new things that have happened in the game, or new creatures that I've unlocked. And there's also, why don't you get Beaver to leave then? No, we're okay. We got it sorted. So we've got Turmoil to speed up everything. Now, never face this. This is going to be interesting. Ooh, I'm excited. Ooh, yes, come on. First time, right? First try. I'm this close to getting Mortem Rex as well. Literally this close. Ooh, okay. Oh, here she comes. She's a glowy. Oh, look, she's got a little bit of steam around her as well. Right, so what do I go for? So obviously Turmoil's going to go for the speed up, right? And then do I hit everything? Is that what I do? I would assume I hit everything, like... So what is this? Just a taunting shield for everybody. Group taunting shield. And that's superior, that's like going first, right? So I'd assume that... I'm just gonna hit everything with the slower. Why is Professor KP not doing anything? Why is he not doing anything? Oh, there we go. There we go. Speed! We needed it. We definitely needed it. Left him right up to the wire there. Get me scared. Oh, okay. We got this. Oh, because there's so many, like, paras here. Or at least there's two paras with the Turmoil and the boss. It sounds like someone's just sawing wood in the background, like... Okay, here we go. Hits everybody. Takes off the shield. Come on, Thor. Oh, the crit! And the crit. And then I get to finish. Did we do good? Wait, what? Oh, is that the slower? Oh, I think that is the slower. Okay, so that's interesting. So this is going to hit everybody as well. And we get the crit too. Oh, less than half health. Turn one. Less than half health. Damn. So yeah, Hadrosaur looks. I'm immune to that. So it has the original Tristornix or Triankular... You know, the T-Rex hybrid, that one that got nerfed as well as Ardentus Maximum. So yeah, Ludia has yet to refund anybody who put boosts into Trichosaurus Rex, that's one, and Ardentus Maximum. Meaning that if you've boosted that, you know, there's nothing you can really do, unfortunately. So what I'm going to do here is just go for a big hit. I'm just going to go for a big hit. I think that's probably the best thing to do, right? I assume... I don't know what the cooldown is with Turmoil. This will be interesting. So the cooldown with the group acceleration is only one, so that's good. However, oh no, it'll be all right. I'm just thinking. So he's going to go for emergency heal on somebody who has the lowest, which could be the Thordor, I think. Wait, what? What did it regenerate that? Oh, right, because he's got the lowest amount of health. I get you. I mean, in terms of everything in total, it hadn't lost the most amount of health, but it had the lowest amount of health. So here comes that. I guess it's the best. So wait, hold on a minute. We have 4 rounds with this thing? 4 flipping rounds with this? Okay, also, I will quickly bring up, according to... this is the DPG Alliance. I've actually went for my best thing. So there is like, because there's 4 rounds. There's normally just 2 with Mortimer. I never even saw that there was so many with this. So what I've got to do is go for deceleration, big hit, instant invincibility. And do that for the first round, second round, and then the third round, I change it. Hold the phone here, guys. With this one, I actually go for, with round 3, just a regular hit. Not too sure why, but apparently I do that. Maybe there's something different? Who knows? This has 10,000 health in total. I didn't even realize that it was 4 turns. Oh my god. Lesser group heal comes with this. Yep. I mean, Turmoil just does the same thing over and over and over. Apparently, the, what's it called? The Baryonyx kind of hybrid does change a couple of times. Thordor, from the looks of it, never changes its things either. So it's gonna be, it's interesting. It's a bit of a slog. So because I've done instant invincibility with everybody, right? Nobody should take hits from this. Oh, never mind. People do take hits because of the counter. Oh, no, is it just for me? It might just be for me. So does that target's maybe the one with the highest health, I think. So here we go, 25,000. So it's 25,000 health each time. Oh my god. And I'm gonna be taunted. Oh no. So this time we're just gonna go for the slower. Instant distraction. Ooh. On everybody, is that? Hmm. So. Right, okay. So what's gonna happen? He's gonna instant distraction our team. And when he does that, I think. Is that a cleanse? Is the Baryonyx hybrid thing, is that cleansing? Does it cleanse? It does cleanse distraction. Perfect. Oh, that's great. That means that basically the Hadrosaur boss didn't do anything. And we get the lucky crit again, doing loads of damage. So it takes 3 turns at least to kill. I mean, we need it to take 3 turns, because if it only takes 2, that means that I'm not going to have my, you know, big hit recharged enough, and neither will the Turmoil. The Turmoil might not get something. Anyway, either way, here comes a hit. Oh, no. So Turmoil is a healer, and then the... What is that thing called? I always forget its name, the Baryonyx hybrid. Is it Tristornyx? So what is the T-Rex hybrid? God knows. So we're on round 2. We're definitely going to do it. So this, maybe there's like play, like some wiggle room with other teams. What is it? Are you Tristornyx? You're Tristornyx. So what is the other one? I have no idea. So with this one, I just go for the biggest hit. I go for big hit here. Round 2. Yeah, Tristornyx does have to go for that. Is it Ankylosaurus Rex? Is that what it's called? I feel like it's a Triankylosaurus Rex or something like that it's called. Now, he doesn't have to do that, but there must be some sort of reason why he goes for that. Oh, a crit! Bam! Now, hopefully, I don't think the Thordor will go for it. I mean, like, get off and kill it, because we don't want that to happen. I mean, does it make much of a difference? Oh, he did it! 2 rounds! That's all it took. That's not good. That's not good. What does that mean? We got crying faces coming from people. I'm trying to think why that is, though. Oh no. Okay, that's it. That's okay. That's okay. The shield comes up. Is this bad? We got crying faces from people, but I don't know why. I mean, we should be quick enough, right? We should be outspeeding them. Oh, wait, we're surrendering? Really? Why was that? I did everything that I was supposed to. We obviously just did too much damage. My Ardentus Maxima is just too strong, apparently. Do we need, like, an unboosted Thor? I have an unboosted Thor. Is Cat's booster? I'll have to double check this. Because it might be, if it is boosted. Let's have a look. Is it boosted? It is boosted by a fair bit, actually. So, do I just want to go for the small hit? And just take out the Gorgo? I think maybe that's what I want to do. I'll go for it. I don't think it's going to make much of a difference, is it? Because usually, with that hit goes straight to the Entlodon, and then the hit coming from Thordor kills it. So I'm assuming that this is going to work. Yeah, with the extra ferocity and the extra crit chance. That's why everything's getting crits, because it's got an increased crit chance. So in comes that to hit everything. Boom! And then I just do a little hit onto what hopefully should be the Gorgosaurus. Is it Gorgosaurus? Gorgosaurus. Go, 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 gaga. That's such a shame. Such a shame. There you go. So we're going to kill it. Third time. So that's so weird. So 3, 6, 9, 12. It's gonna take 12 rounds. Good God. Ludia, what were you thinking? I thought 2 rounds was enough. But I'm wondering if there's any other strategies that people have came up with to do this. I'm sure there are. So should I slow it? I mean, I think I should just go for regular hits, if I'm gonna be honest. I'm apparently too powerful, so what you gonna do? I'm just checking to make sure that, oh, don't you love that? The Symphony of Dead Dinosaurs. It's beautiful. Go for Decel Rampage turn 1. Resilient Strike turn 2. And Shield up. Okay, so I just never go for the big hit. I don't even think I need to go for it, if I've got to be honest. I think I can just go for the regular each time, and the amount of damage is going to come through from Thordor and Tristornix. I think it's going to be... Like, well, I'll just go for the biggest hit. Oh no, I need to go for a shield. Oh, that's right. Ooh, okay, so let's see what Thordor does here. Because Thordor can just go... I think he's got 2 that hit everybody, or maybe just 1 hits everybody. So let's see, let's see. So we got... Is that 16,000 health left to take off? Because that's a lot. So we can definitely do 5,000. I'll go for the shield, and then everybody else just goes for a big hit. And I'd assume that's enough. So what I should have done here is a load more damage. So I'll go for the instant shield. Big hit coming from Tristornix. A small hit coming from Thordor? But you can just go for Fierce Impact, right? And just guarantee that you've done it. I think that's what they should have done. Okay, okay. Well, anyway, let's see if this works. Imagine if we don't kill it in turn 3. That's interesting. It's a case of, like, with Mortem Rex, it was trying to do as much damage to it as possible. This one, it's juggling how much damage you can do to it. So we've got 2 big hits coming through here. Hopefully we get a crit. We haven't killed it turn 3. We haven't killed it turn 3. Is that bad? I mean, I guess it's not losing territory, apparently. But, oh god, it depends. So this goes for the one with the most speed. And I guess because I can't be sped reduced, that's me. Okay, so do we just go for, like, a little one now? Just a little love taps? Just, eh. So turn 4, would you believe? And then, yeah, I guess. It's not bad. It gives everybody a chance to get the moves that they want off. Should Professor KP go for it? Like the speed boosty? Because no, because everyone's gonna get decelerated, so no, don't go for the speed boost. Just go for decelerating. Oh, the group superiority, yeah. Because then he's gonna go first, everyone's gonna get the speed boost, and then everything is gonna be hit and reduce speed, so there's no point in that. Oh, I like it. No way. I'm looking at my recording, it says it's been 30 minutes. It has not been 30 minutes. It's probably taken like 20 minutes to get the bloody game going. But hey-ho, here we are. So we probably could have done it first turn. I just didn't realize that we needed to. And my Ardennis Maxima apparently... Okay, don't know what happened there. Think I must have hit the cable. Not so good. I'm gonna put the... Ooh, I'll put it there. Always with the pro setups here at the Gaming Beaver Channel. So there we go. Round two taken out. So this time, I'll just go for... The slowing down hits everybody, and then I'll also go for the regular hit, and then the shield. Okay. And that should work. And this time the Tristonix can heal itself. So there we go. We got it this time. Three turns here on out. So 3, 6, 9, 12. That only takes to 12 out of 20 turns max that you can do. Okay. Ah, the crit! Not that it's needed, because it's going to be killed by Thorno. And the group distraction, which... Does everyone have a resistance to it? I think it looked like everyone had a resistance to it. Okay, so critical chance. I'm curious to see what my critical chance is now. Oh, it's 60%! What is it for a Thorno then? It's got to be like 100% chance. Okay. There it is. So we need a group heal on everybody. Oh my god, I'm hungry. Oh, I'm so hungry. I'm looking at the Discord and there's a little section that was like 5-foot sub. So after I saw that and I've said it, I could go for it actually. No, James, you've got to make your wraps at home. Wait, what? I thought I had zero health there. No, that's not me. That's them. Don't be silly, James. They're knocked out. They're done for. Look at that. There's some childbearing hips there. That had Russell. Good God. Are we okay? We're good. Okay, so now I just go for little ones. Just go for little hits. So the reason why the Tristonix not only can go for the heal here is just so it doesn't do any damage to it. Because Thordo is going to do in two hits... like 10,000 damage to it, basically. So we want me to do a hit, he'll do his little hit, and that'll take it to about 3,000 health now, I would say. And then he's gonna do, if he gets a crit, it's 5,000 damage, and we've made it. And then I can just go for shield, everything else can go for the little hits. Ooh, hey, it takes some time, but we get there. There it is, 5,000, so yeah, 3,000, like I thought. And now you needing that shield. I mean, once Turamorlock like, goes for it, I mean, oh, does that do any damage? Oh, good lord. Turamorlock, like, go for your, I'll go for the shield here. Yeah, Turamorlock, like, lesser heal? I would say at this point, unless it's already done its greater heal, which it might have done on the Tristonix, which was a bit of a shame. It should have saved it for thingy there. It should have saved it for the Thordo, because we need that to survive. Really need it to survive. So there it is. That's it taken out. Comes in from the group heal, which I guess does heal the Tristonix. Does it get hit? Yeah, it heals the Tristonix. It heals the Turamorlock, and it heals just a little bit. Squish, just a little bit of the Thordo. Yeah, well, actually, 2,300 is a fair bit. But Thordo has to hit it. There's no way that Thordo cannot hit it. So, I mean, he's going to get hit here. And then he's going to get hit again with the next turn. Interesting that this is... I wonder if Lydia thought about this. They thought that because Adonis Maxima can't be slowed, that this would work in favor for doing, you know, hitting the high, the speediest. Because there's no way, if you were Erlikosaurus or something, which I think is immune to speed reduction, that's always going to hit Erlikosaurus. So there's no way doing this strat will work for Erlikosaurus or Erlidominus or whatever it's called. Because it'll always be hit. That's interesting. So also after this, we will have a look at all the new dinosaurs that I've unlocked, that I've managed to unlock. I will, spoilers, there's only two dinosaurs in the entire game I haven't unlocked. I've been a good boy. And not too long ago, we got the Ardennis Maxima, not Ardennis Maxima, Gemini Titan tournament. So I've got a whole bunch of DNA from that. Yeah, I'm just wondering, should I have done this? Yeah, because it starts with the same amount of health. Oh, no! Don't hit Thordo. Turmoil's probably going to go for the boost here anyway. And so the priority heal, which is definitely going to heal Thordo, probably to max health. So here I go. So round three, the furthest we've ever made it. Wow. Breaking records here. Yeah, there's no... Look at the minions are just completely nullified at this point. I mean, it does make sense that they're there because it does mean that we have to... Like, Turamolic is just so freaking good. You really don't need Dilocheris anymore. Really don't need Dilocheris. So that's another dinosaur that I kind of want to take the boosts off. Because to start with, it was like, oh yeah, Dilocheris is really good. And then everyone turned their attention to Turamolic and thought, wait a minute. Turamolok's really freaking good, which is, I mean, I could max Turamolok to level 30, and that way, like, everybody wants a Turamolok in their team, because then you can kind of go for anything you want. It does that priority for speed boost, and it also has the priority heal and the group heal, as well as, if you want, I guess, the superiority heal, slowing strike or whatever it is, which I guess isn't too bad. Oh, look at Thordo, back with the full health. God, this takes a while, this one, doesn't it? Yay! Round three, here we go. People are wanting to help. So there's a waiting line. Oh, wait, should I? Wait, what? Oh, good lord! Didn't see that. Did not see that. Okay, so this time I just go for one with the lowest health. So this isn't a group superiority, is it? It's not. I guess I'll do it just in case. It's going to target the one with the lowest health, which in this case... Oh, wait, hold on. There we go. I do the taunt. That's what you do. It's the taunt that works. It's like, wait, no, he's probably still going to target him. And then he'll be on like no health, if not dead. But because I've got, that's why not only, I'm probably not the fastest, let's be honest, but that's why it's a target, the taunt. When this update was put in, oh, we've got 40 health left. Oh, hold on. Gamer, Discord. Hi, the Gaming Beaver. I'm a big fan. Thank you. Got a notification there. Okay, so because I got my taunt, there it is, completely nullified. Joke's on you. So here it is, the final turn. Turn four. Woo! Interesting. We're gonna do it. Defeating Hadrosaurus Lux. Right, so this time I guess it doesn't really matter, does it? We just want to kill it. But we could have done it a turn earlier. I was a bit of an idiot. And I should have went for the slowing. Because I did my regular hit, it didn't hit Hadrosaur Lux. So there was already like a turn down, or sorry, a damage down. And because my Ardentus Maxima is pretty baller with the damage in terms of Ardentus Maxima, and it does 1.5 damage. It was a lot. It was a big hit that I didn't do that. So here we go. Boom! Everybody dies. Now, if I went for my regular hit, I think Gorgosaurus, might have survived here. So I'm glad that I did go for that. Yeah, I think he would have because I got 1,800 attack. I didn't even get the crit. Whoa, what are crit chances here? 60% to get a crit, didn't get it. Or did Tristonix actually just go for a bite here? I think it might have went for a bite. I was not paying attention, not going to lie. At this point, you zone out by turn four, don't you? So we're just going to go for big hits here. Big hits all around. Maybe we can make it up. Let's target boss. Okay. Let's go. Let's kill him. Oh god, I'm really hungry now. Oh my god, Beaver, so relatable. I'm hungry too. Big hit. Small hit. And, excuse me. Rumbly tummy. Don't know if you heard that. I definitely wouldn't have picked it up with the in-game music and the music I put over the top. You definitely wouldn't have heard that. Oh, there we go. Or shall I just like try and find that bit in the audio and try to like maximize, like compress the hell out of it? So you can hear my stomach gurgle. So if I do 5,000 and odd damage here. Oh, hold on. Yes, we did it. We did it with three turns each because we did it in two this time. And hopefully, excuse me. If he gets a crit, he's definitely killed him. Oh, there we go! Taken out, long, fall down. Adrasil looks. Oh, beautiful. Well played, team. Well done. Well done. Oh, do you not get to taunt her? You don't get to say anything at the end. Oh, that's a shame. Well, thank. Oh God, they. can we? Okay. Well, apparently that's just stuck here. So we're just gonna open it with that over the top. So that's nice. Thank you, Mammoth. Okay, what are we gonna get? We're gonna 167. So this is it. 100. Let's see if we can get 100. Can I not reject this? Can't reject it. Can't. Okay, here we go. Here we go. Come on. And it is 20. I guess it's not so resilient. Of course it's resilient. Do you hear that sound effect? That was nice, wasn't it? Thank you, Ouya Ouya. You're going to be muted forever now. Have some pretty music. So, we had the Gemini Titan event, which meant that, you know, we can basically... I don't know, do many people use Gemini Titan anymore? Is it still useful? It probably is. It's a health tank. I mean, the definite shield advantage and the group accelerating is pretty decent, as well as it basically being immune to everything, as the main one being speed decrease. Distraction's pretty good. The stun's also very good. And if you want to swap it, that's good too. So I think about that. I do have almost 15,000 bucks to spend. I kind of want to do a live stream where I just spend hours just going through battles and opening up incubators to get as many boosts as possible. Because we could, if we wanted to, go in the market and buy. Oh no, it's not even an option. You see, boost used to be every day, but I think Ludia picked up on, you know, like the amount of booster creatures that are out there. At this point, it's too late, Ludia. You kept them in for like half a year, so if anyone has been paying or cheating the game or whatever, they've got the books that they needed to max out their creatures. But anyway, what do you think? What dinosaurs do you think I haven't maxed up? If you're paying attention, you already know one of them. But what have I done? There we go. So the only one that I don't have is Hadrosaur Lux and Mortem Rex. I have everything else. He did it. Hey, you crazy son of a gun. You did it. Deodocorus. Here we go. Oh, look at it. Get to unlock it. Little cannonball. I'm assuming, yeah, it's resilient, so it's going to be a lot of health. That's a level 6. I wish you could see what it would be like at level 30. You know, like you do with Jurassic World, the game. You click on it and you'll see what it will be at level 30. So that's a shame, because it would be so cool. You could be like, oh, maybe I should. So this was the most recent unique hybrid. The Bowser. Bowser. Oh my god, it does look like a Koopa Troopa or something. It's definitely, it's Bowser. I kind of want to use this thing. I'd love to have him. It's got a fluffy tail. Oh my god. Oh, it looks so weird. It looks like something from like a monster movie that was in the black and white era. You know, the Claw, I think it was called, with that horrible sound. Persistent Ferocious Strike. Emergency Heal, which is decent. Group Decelerating Impact, which is all right. And Bellow. What is fun? It can't be speed decreased. Oh, well, at 104 base speed. Yeah, that's really going to help. Now, Model Orion. This thing I've seen a lot of. And, we, of course, the championship or whatever for the Elasmotherium DNA. So I got 3,000 Elasmotherium DNA for that. So if I wanted to, I could start using for this guy. Yeah. Yeah, maybe. I've seen some people use it. Now, it is one of the few wild cards out there. I mean, it's versatile and able to support teams in any kind of capacity. I mean, it can do a lot of damage. It can do... it has a lot of health as well. How do I get rid of this? Oh, exit. There it is. So what does it have? Cunning Strike, Definite Impact, Group Shield, and Taunting Shield. Now, what you want to do is boost all the attack on it and then do the swap in Stunning Strike. Goes through Shield... And, you know, you get that to, what, 2,000 odd damage? That's guaranteed 2,000 damage on a switch in. Plus, it has a lot of health. And it can do all of this stuff as well. It can do Definite Impact and Cunning Strike. It's very... I can see why people use it now. And this thing, which was a recent one, I think everyone got it in an incubator because it was just around the strike events. Sonorous. Sonorosaurus? Sonorosaurus. Never heard of this thing before. Another Brachiosaurus. Alright, alright. So, Resilient Strike, Taunting Vulnerability, Devastation. Ooh. That's three times the attack, right? It is. I think there's only one creature that has that, and I think that's the tortoise, right? I think that's the only one that has it. So medium resilient counterattack. Interesting. And what is it? Immune to speed decrease, which I guess is all right, but you're not going to speed increase. 105, actually. A little bit faster than, I think, that one speed increase really does help. It's faster than a lot of things. And finally, good lord, this thing, the testicles. Testacornibus. This I would have not got if it wasn't for the championships or tournaments, whatever it was, because I got like 200 of it. And really, there was no way to kind of find the, what's it called, this one? The Euclodoceros, or the Irish elk, is it? Or Scottish elk, or something like that. It's a colloquial name, because I was using... Nezutoceratops is hard to come by, but I was also using Carbonemis for Smilonemis, I think it was at the time. So that is everything, and we are 30 away from Mortem Rex. Damn. Literally just a couple of unlucky opens of the incubators, pulling some 10s. And I would, if I hadn't pulled those 10s, if I pulled the like three 20s instead of three 10s, we would have been there. We would have got this. But saying that, though, there's a lot of people that are still only halfway to getting it. So I'm very lucky. I appreciate that. I'm very lucky of getting that thing. But yeah, that was fun, actually. Another different kind of boss creature to take on. I really wish that... Have they changed Odendus Maximus' picture? They've changed Odendus Maximus. They've given him a longer snout. They can't leave Odendus alone. They won't refund me these. Because this is the thing, right? Odendus Maxima is pretty decent against Mortem Rex. But I spent 1,800 boosts on it. So, and it was nerfed, meaning that those boosts are kind of wasted. It was almost on 11,000 health. It's on 9,600 health. Come on, man. It lost about 500 to 600 health. It's ridiculous. Well, absolutely ridiculous. And I can't get my boost back without losing half of them. Look, do you want to 50 refund instead of 100? No! I don't want to do that. What Ludia needs to do is set a precedent and say, look, right, what's going to happen here is every month or every 2 or 3 months, whatever you want to call it, a term, a quarter, business, whatever, everyone gets their boosts back. And that way, I'll be like, okay, so I did try it with this. I'm not going to refund it. I'm going to keep it back. But if I do really want to, I'll refund it and try on something right now. So the option's there. Or what they can do, which actually, I think that one's probably the best option. Option B, which isn't the best, is when they do change something, which is pretty much every update. They change everything. Everything gets like a little bit extra health, a little bit less attack, something like that. So everything gets tweaked. Now, if the things that are changed... You get your boost back. Now, with Odendus Maxima, a lot of people boosted it, which is why there was a lot of outcry. And with this guy, Trichosaurus, that's the one. Trichosaurus got its counter changed, so now it no longer speed reduces, and I don't think it ever went through armor. But it got speed reduced, which definitely changed, and I think some of its other stats would change. Now, a lot of people had boosted Trichosaurus and Odendus Maxima, which... There was a lot of outcry when those dinosaurs, said dinosaurs, were changed. But what if somebody, for the hell of it, has boosted Secodonosaurus? And, you know, there's no outcry about that because nobody uses it. So there's only one voice. So I think every 3 months, 4 months, quarter, whatever you want to call it, refund the boosts. Or every update. So that way, even if people have boosted an obscure dinosaur, they're going to get them back. That's my two cents. Let me know what you think down in the comments. And anyway, guys, thank you for sticking around. This has been a long one, but that was a long air tournament. But we've unlocked loads of creatures. I'm just trying. Is there anything else I can do? Not really. Here I am, down in Lockwood Manor. To be fair, since the new, Odendus Maxima was completely nerfed, I have not got up to or stayed very long in what's the Gyrosphere Station. And that's because all of my stuff is locked in there. So there's literally no... I think I maybe once I got into Nublar Shores and then I was taken out straight away. Only once ever. And that was ages ago. So now getting into Gyrosphere Depot, That's a win for me, which is so sad. But anyway, guys, if you enjoyed this video, leave a like, and until next time, I'll see you later. Oh, bye-bye.